Hello friends, today we have the winners of the PSBT Film Challenge with us in both professional and amateur categories, and I am very happy to introduce these bright young filmmakers to you. We have Harjeet Singh, who's made the film Samrat Phone, and he's got this award in the professional category. These films are under 10 minutes, so it was a big challenge for sure for the filmmakers, because the shorter the format is, the challenge becomes greater. And then we have Paromita Bora and Moshumi Kalita, whose film, Semicolon, won the award in the amateur category. So we have all the filmmakers here, and let's have a conversation. Let's get rolling and let's ask them, what inspired them in the first place to make these films? So who will start first? Go ahead.
Yeah.
Okay, Harjeet.
Actually, what inspired me was the pain of that family in which there were two kids, and due to COVID, schools were closed and they were supposed to join online classes. So because lack of resources compelled them to sell their household things in order to buy the cell phones for their kids. So that pain made me to think about this short film.
Yeah. So actually, you are right that a lot was happening around us, which inspired us to make these films. But then, you know, why did you choose fiction and why didn't you go the documentary way? Any particular reason for choosing the format?
Actually, I'm comfortable with the fictional stories.
Mm-hmm.
So it was a good opportunity for me to make this short film on this family.
Your earlier work also, does it revolve around fiction? You're a PhD.
Yes.
It's very fascinating to note, you know, that you've done a PhD on the films that have been done by Gulzar.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, one of my favorite writers too. Yeah. Okay.
All the short films I have done, these are all fiction films, narrative films. I haven't made any documentary.
Yeah. And Moshumi and Paromita, what was your inspiration?
Our inspiration was like when I heard about PSBT challenge, one of my friends told me you can join there. Then I called Paromita because recently we both were talking and working together two, three things. So like I called her and I said, I have a story in my mind. So let's work on it and how we can go through it. So I actually have a PG myself. A girl's PG I own.
Mm-hmm.
So I saw when there was a lockdown was declared, and I saw how the girls rushed home and how it was difficult for them to go in a, actually it was very unpredictable for everybody that time, the first time the lockdown. Mm-hmm. So they had rushed home. From that time, if this thing came in my mind, if somebody cannot go and they have to go somewhere, and this molestation things which will haunt her, because being a girl, we all know we have faced this kind of molestation from family members or relatives or friends or whatever. So we discussed it and we came forward and like that.
So Harjeet, where was your film shot and how much time did it take you to find characters? And because, you know, you filmed it in a period of lockdown.
Yes.
So it must have had its own challenges. So can you just tell us more about it?
I shot this film at Punjab University Patiala.
Okay.
I'm teaching at Punjab University Patiala. I'm staying in the campus. So it was easy for me to shoot inside the campus, because we have a very comfortable zone, and there is a security, so there were no problem. So the characters and then the actors I found within the campus.
Oh, very lucky, I must say.
Yeah.
Because they are such natural actors, all of them. Especially that girl, the little girl is like
Yeah, it was very difficult. It was very difficult to shoot in winter because the period that I have shown is the summer.
Summers, yeah.
But we shot it in December, so it was very difficult for that small girl to shoot, and she was shivering.
Wow. And what was your crew size?
We were it was a team of 10 people, including actors. Oh. And actors were also working behind the camera.
Very interesting. Yeah, because you know the lockdown has its own challenges.
Yeah.
So if we take out, I mean, the actors, that means you were a crew of 4 to 5 people.
Yes.
Yeah. Okay.
The main character who played the role of the father, and he was also working behind the camera.
Oh, wow. And how much time did it take you?
It took us 2 days to complete the film.
Okay.
Yeah.
And how much time to edit?
Around 5 to 6 days it took.
Okay. So in about 10 days, one can say that.
Yeah, we completed
the film.
Yeah. Yes.
Wow. I think it's a brave effort. Definitely. Yeah. And Paromita and Moshumi, what was your journey right from finding the characters to locations to the crew sites?
It was pretty convenient for us to find the people because Mosmi had her the lead character, so Mosmi already knew her, and that's why we could just picturize her in that sort of character, that particular girl. And we all had friends, actually friends of her, friends. Mm-hmm. friends. And then we would communicate with all of them and convince them basically of this story. And shooting during the lockdown, the interiors were not that much of a trouble. This is somebody's house. Please give us for a day or something like that. Yeah. But on the roads, to actually show the entire lockdown period, because that when the time when we shot it, it was not full lockdown. So to give the feeling of that it was a lockdown time, we had to select times of the day where traffic would be very less, people would be very less, shops were closed and all. So that's all.
Yeah, very interesting. And how much time did it take for you to film this?
Couple of days.
Yeah. 3 days for shooting, and then editing maybe 2-3 days. But the music, I think it took maybe then.
The
guy who did music for us, he was also new, so that's he was also a friend of us. So it took a little bit of time.
So, what were the highs and lows of your filmmaking? Please share. I would love to know. Arjeet, tell us something interesting which happened, something which elated you.
Nothing as such. It was very simple process. It was cold, so we were shooting and we were eating together, we were working together. And we were making efforts to complete the film on time because there was a deadline that was approaching. But it was very difficult to work with that small girl.
Okay.
That was the most difficult part of the process, but we made it.
Yeah, but I think she was, I'm sure it was difficult, but she wasn't an actor. But then I think ultimately it worked for you. I mean, her innocence, you know, like, because of her, you know, you are also, it's not just her father who's worried about her education. Ultimately, it gets to you as a viewer, you also want to know whether she'll be able to study or not. And then ultimately, but the end was heartbreaking. Why did you pull the phone out of her hand?
Because this is the problem our society is still facing when we have to make choice whether the boy will be joining online classes or the girl will be joining online classes. So mother decides that it will be the boy who will be studying online. So again, we are biased.
But as a filmmaker, doesn't it sometimes, you know, confuse you? What should be the ending? Should you be sending the right message that, you know, the phone should remain in girls' hands? Or should you just show the reality? and say no, most of the times the phone goes to the boy. So didn't you ever face this conundrum in your heart?
No, the phone goes to the phone goes to the boy.
Yeah.
So it is the reality.
It is the reality.
It is the reality. Yes.
Okay. I wish you had manipulated it a bit. It would have made me happier. Okay. And how was your experience? Please tell us about your highs and lows, both of you.
Yeah, highs and lows means actors were non-actors, but they were very natural. So it was there was no problem while shooting and all. But I have my baby with me, so it was winter. And Parameter used to come and stay in my home, so I have to take her for shooting at till 1 o'clock, and for editing and this also, I like music thing also, I have to always carry her, so that was a little hard, but it was good. Overall, it was a good experience working with these people. And Parameter,
you also me. Yeah, please. Yeah. Add.
Yeah. There were a lot of highs, like highs because shooting time would be fun because they are very cooperative. They were very cooperative, but non-actors, to get them to acting or of what we want of the product, it was a fun experience. Whatsoever the pressure, it was a good experience to like, not like this, but that and that. And apart from the positives, there was, I didn't feel any pressure or while going about the shooting, there was no pressure as such. Apart from that, yeah, the deadline and what happened, the struggle happened in the later end, probably when that I already mentioned, like the to show that it's empty road, we had to get up early morning when it, and yeah, show that it was the afternoon. And yeah, that's all. But yeah, the girl and the father, the sister and her husband, they were all naturals. There were little fun moments which was giving the high, but apart from that, it was pretty smooth.
Yeah. The film is really gripping, you know, because you also want to know what will become of the girl. Will she find a secure place, a safe place or not? And you just left the ending hanging. We don't know what happened to her. That perhaps that's why you called it semicolon.
Yeah. We never know what is the ending. It's just a pause.
Yeah. Semicolon is actually very appropriate that way. And Harjeet, whereas your film is concerned, the title is equally interesting. Samrat Phone.
Yeah. During lockdown, smartphone became the smartphone because it was difficult for small families to have a smartphone to join the online classes. So that's why we titled it Samrat Phone.
I don't know. It also looks like a pun on the people who rule our country. I don't know.
Yeah.
Because the way the mom says, you know, wo phone to minister dega. Jhoote vaade kabhi pure honge nahi.
Yeah. The people are still waiting for the smartphone in Punjab.
Yeah. So that's very interesting. So in fact, a lot of filmmaking has changed during these times, you know, like people like us, me and my co-director Nandan Saxena, we make films on human rights, on farmers' issues, on gender issues, and we travel a lot. We are used to traveling so much. And suddenly, you know, you find that you are just inside your house, not going anywhere. Both of us are also doing a film, a documentary we are doing. And we turned the lens inwards. We turned the lens on us, on our own lives, on our own thoughts in this period. Stuck up in a high rise in Mumbai. And what are we feeling? What are our thoughts? So it's kind of a self-reflexive film as well. So it's very interesting how. And then I was looking at, you know, a lot of world cinema is going the same way. You find that a lot of people are making now films related to the lockdowns, which is a very fascinating genre that has come up during this time. As they say, you know, that every dark cloud has a silver lining. I think this content, these films, that we are creating is the silver lining of our times. This is what I feel. So tell me, where should we go now from here? You decide. I don't have to decide everything. Anything that you want to tell, anything you want to share, they are your films. And everybody is listening to you right now. Tell us about the challenges of the independent filmmakers.
First challenge is the funding.
Yeah.
That is a basic problem that we face. So you have to pay each and every one. So it is the biggest problem.
Yeah.
So sometimes I have stories and I cannot go on the floor because of lack of the budget. But at least I have pen and paper and keep on writing.
There are many, a few national, but a lot of international pitching forums where you can pitch your ideas and find collaborators. It's a long process. There is no doubt about it. But thanks to the internet, we can at least now connect to the world. We can take our work to the world. We can look for collaborators. I think that is a very big plus point now. Yeah.
Yes.
So there is hope. Keep writing.
Yes.
Keep working. And Moshmi and Paramita, please add, what do you feel about the challenges of independent
challenges? The main challenge is funding only. When we were about to shoot this film, we didn't have any producer. Who will produce it? Then we called our DOP editor. He's actually one of our friend only. So tell him that you have to do it for us. Will you be able to? He said, we are not going to pay you anything. So he said, I will be, but just other things like camera and everything we have to hire, no? So actually, regarding direction and story writing and everything, which we are comfortable with, then Paramita is also comfortable with. But the technical part like camera or anything or music, other things, we are not comfortable with that. We don't know that much about it. So always we need fun for that. So if we have something in our mind also, we just cannot go through it. So fun is the main problem. Later on, other things can be sorted. Yeah, Paramita, what do you want to say?
I was actually just adding on to yours because of the funding, like we did not use any light. We had no light because we could not. We had to give mobile torches thing to give an effect that she's.
I noticed that.
Dim light
and lamp also.
a lot of things like. So funding will probably is the one of the biggest issues. Just that it makes the because we are. Independent and amateur, like we are beginning. We are not independent and we are there or we are known or something. We have this two problems, challenges, not really that's going to stop us, but then yes, that we are independent and we are very small. We are independent like at a very personal and level, na? So we have to like compromise on a lot of things to just get the work done. She has invested to do the film for the DOP and all from her own personal lot, no? So this sort of thing will end up giving us like less budget to make a quality out of it. So all we could do was spend as bare minimum as possible, but also make a good product out of it.
But look how well you did. Both your film and Harjeet's film have won an award. Like such a beautiful thing that you have done well. And for me, you are not small. I mean, frankly, you say you are small, it's okay. It may be your self-perception, but I will feel that all independent filmmakers are very big. The very fact that they choose to walk the path, which is not easy, is a very big thing in life. As you keep walking, you'll meet collaborators, you'll meet co-farers, and you'll meet people, you know, who'll make your journey happier. And on this positive note, I congratulate all of you once again.
Thank you.
And good luck.
Thank you so much.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Bye.